My name is Jason Gutman, and I'm a gastroenterologist for Rochester Regional Health. Today we're going to be talking about debunking some of the myths that are associated with colorectal cancer screening and colonoscopies. Myth number one, screening is only necessary for individuals who have symptoms. Screening tests are designed to investigate patients who do not have symptoms because we're looking for disease or precancerous lesions specifically with colon cancer. The ultimate goal is therefore to try to prevent the development of colon cancer if patients do have polyps and removing them or finding colon cancer at an earlier stage so that they have a better chance at cure. Myth two, preparing for colonoscopy is hard. With any procedure, there is oftentimes a preparation that people have to undergo in regards to colonoscopy. There is a process of patients getting cleaned out beforehand so that we can get a good look at the tissue. In most cases, patients tolerate this very well, but if they do have problems, we have ways of helping out or modifying the preparation. Myth number three, a colonoscopy is unpleasant and painful. A lot of patients do have concerns about whether or not they'll be uncomfortable during the procedure, but fortunately, with the procedure, we do give them a pain medication and a sedative, and in combination, these two will last about 30 minutes, which is the length of the procedure. Patients, like I said, will often sleep through it, and when they wake up, they won't realize that it was done. Myth four, colonoscopies are embarrassing. Colonoscopies are something that we do on a regular basis. Each endoscopist typically does over 1,000 procedures a year. Our goal is to make the patient as comfortable as possible, and we maintain privacy and comfort throughout the process of the procedure. Myth five, colonoscopies are just for screening. Colon polyps are very common. About 40% of patients will have polyps at the time of their first screening colonoscopy. When we do the procedure, as long as the polyps are small enough, typically we can remove them. I would say about 99% of all polyps can be removed at the time of the initial colonoscopy. There are other options for screening, including doing stool tests in which we look for blood. This would be done on a yearly basis. If patients are found to have blood in their stool, then they would proceed to a colonoscopy. There are different options, as I mentioned, and patients should talk to their doctors about what's best for them.